Coming to the temple is that we're very fortunate to come here, because the temple is not an ordinary place, it is not a mundane place. It is such a nun. It is the manifestation of the Surup Shakti, the Supreme Lord, the Personality of Godhead. And it's Tadiya, the Supreme Lord. Radhanam Sarvisham Vishnu Radhanapuram Tasmatpratram Devim Tariyanam Sanachanam. And the great Mahadeva said to Devi, to Parvati, you should understand one thing, Devi, that of all the worship of the devatas, the worship of Supreme Lord Vishnu is topmost. And even more important than the worship of Vishnu himself is the worship of his Tariya. Those Vaishnavas are very dear to him. His own family members, his own dear associates, his own devotees. Because why is this so? You have to understand the Shastra says, Guru Krishna Upahana Shastra Pama, Guru Rupa Krishna Kripa Kurana Bhakti Gama. That the Supreme Personality of Godhead manifests in the form of Guru. This is written in Shastra. And the Diksha Guru represents the form of Krishna, Supreme Lord. Because it is in this form that Krishna bestows his mercy upon the devotees. Guru Rupa Krishna Kripa Kurana Bhakti Gama. And then, therefore, those persons who have found their way to the lotus feet of a bona fide spiritual master are beginning their pathway out of their material existence. Sri Krishna also says in the Adi Purana, in his discussion with Arjuna, he says, you should know, Arjuna, that those people, when their time for their bondage, their sojourn in this material existence is coming to an end, the signal of that end is that they start to attain the association of the sadhu, they attain sadhusanga. And that's a chance for them to actually return back to home, back to Godhead. And Siksha Guru Keta Jani Krishna Shu Antaryami Bhakti Shrestha Edu. Siksha Guru Keta Jani Krishna Shu. That Siksha Guru, that person who takes the responsibility for giving instructions on behalf of the Supreme Lord, is actually the Swarup of Krishna, Krishna's heart, Krishna's personality, Krishna's desire. The Supreme Lord manifests in the form of the sadhus, and Krishna has so much attachment for them, he even says that he follows after them and collects the dust from their feet, and he wants to purify himself in the dust of the feet of his own devotees. So Antaryami Bhakti Shrestha. So within, he's prompting from within as a super soul and as a topmost devotee Bhakti Shrestha. Edu, with those two forms, from within and without, Krishna's always prompting to the negative. And then the Shastra says, what of Edu Guru? Jiva Sakshat Nahi? Tati Guru Chetrupe? Siksha Guru Vaya Krishna Mahanta Shurupe? That the conditioned soul, we cannot directly perceive the Supreme Lord within us. We cannot directly understand what is the truth, what is the actual substance of existence. So therefore, even though the super soul is prompting us, most of us are unable to receive that instruction clearly. And the presence of the super soul is there. So therefore, he appears before the jiva, Siksha Guru Hoya Krishna, he appears as a Siksha Guru. And therefore, Krishna Mahantra Shurupe, the great soul is also known from Krishna. It's so important to have a guru. We have to approach, we have to understand that once you enter the path of spiritual life, you're approaching the path of truth. Because any other conception beyond the Krishna consciousness conception is a path of falsehood and self-deception. We become the self-deceiver. If we don't fully surrender to the lotus feet of the spiritual master and the mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There's one very famous extract from the Smriti Shastra, which was one young boy named, his name was Satyakama, and his mother was called Jabala. And his mother was a serving maid. She worked in many different places. And Satyakrama did not know who his father was. And one day he heard about a sadhu called Gautama Rishi. And he started to hear about the glories of transcendental knowledge and Vedvidya. Just as today as the appearance day of the Supreme Lord Jagannath Dev, to honor his appearance day, his Snanantra, who also performed at Homa, Vaishnava Homa, the Singha Yagya, Maharaj chanted the Sudarshan. So much auspiciousness was there. So this powerful Vedic knowledge has been passed down from guru to disciple since time immemorial. So he started to understand the importance of finding a guru and understanding the truth. And he went to that guru. He went to that guru. But first he asked his mother, Mother, you must tell me who is my father. What is my gotra? What is my lineage? And she said, Son, I've only been a serving maid. I've worked in many different houses. And I cannot tell you who is your father. So your name is Satyakama Jabala. You've taken the name of your mother. So he didn't understand the gravity of this in a traditional society. But still he wanted to go and get transcendental knowledge. So he approached the sage Gautama. Of course, not that this is out of bounds for anyone. To go beyond the limitations of social etiquette is not available. But he went there with a sincere heart and approached that sage. He said, "Oh, Sadhuji, Rishinan, please accept me as a disciple. I want to train under you. I want you to teach me. What is the meaning of life? What is transcendental knowledge?" And Gautama looked at him and he said, "Yes, first you tell me what is your Gotra, who is your father?" And that boy looked at him fearlessly and said, "Well, Rishinan, my mother told me that she worked in many different houses, and she cannot tell me who is my father. So therefore my name is Satya Paramajavala. I've taken the name of my mother." And normally, if you understand the strictness of society, at that point, the superior person will not accept that person, become angry, say, "Get out from here. You have no qualification, no sanskar, no yati dharma, no kula dharma. You cannot approach the level of my teaching." But still, that Gautama, he saw the one principle in that devotee that was the most important thing in spiritual life. He saw that he was truthful, therefore his name is Satyakama. He says, "Because you've been honest, you haven't tried to deceive me, you haven't tried to hide your identity." In the same way that this, what's his name now? Ekalava wanted to learn from Dronacharya, but Dronacharya wasn't available to him. He lived in the forest, so he made a murti out of clay and started worshipping the murti, the vigraha of his guru. And therefore, he got the transmission from the transcendental platform from his guru to be able to become the greatest archer. But his learning was illegitimate. And in the end, Dronacharya was not happy, so I said, "Give me a thumb," and he disabled him. But in this case, Satyakama, he had one quality which is outstanding. He had truthfulness. And in Kali Yuga, the last leg of the cow, which is outstanding, is truthfulness. If we can just hang on to truth, we're honest in all our dealings. Sometimes truthful things may be uncomfortable to think to say, but still, if we can express an uncomfortable truth in a humble and polite way, we'll never be defeated by Maya. So this is the thing. This is the qualities Krishna says by which the Brahmanas work. And if we aspire to, first of all, attain Sadhu Sangha, surrender yourself to the greatest feet of those sadhus, purify ourselves by their association, by hearing from them, Satam Prasantam Mamaviri Sambhira, or Vantira Karma, that's all enough. Then our heart will become free from the shackles of untruth, of falsehood. We'll walk in the truth of Krishna consciousness. We'll path to eternal life will be open to us, and we'll be able to see everyone as Mahaprabhu always instructed us, to know the peace, and to know the peace, and to know the money, and to know the peace, and to have enough humility in our heart to walk faithfully and happily in any situation, and see the hand of the Lord in everything that happens to us. Just as Srila Bhakti Rakshakshidharma used to say, the environment is always friendly. So we take shelter of the words of those Mahajans, we pray at the lotus feet, we pray at the lotus feet of our spiritual master, Srila Prabhupada, that their grace will come in our life, we can progress on the path of bhakti, and that we can have faith with them. And we pray at the lotus feet of our Maharaj, he's very merciful, very kind, he's come all the way to Australia to help us with his mercy, and we ask that he will tell us tonight the truths of the philosophy of Krishna. Ecstatic feel back together and understand how to become happy forever. My Guru Maharaj, Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj, always said, always remember one thing: if you have faith in this chanting, this Hare Krishna mantra, there will be no more suffering or sorrow in this world or in the next forevermore. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Bhaktaya Tad Bhaktaya Namo Namah. Vanchakalpadurvasa kripa sindhu bhairvacha patitanam bhavanipho vaisnave Ajanulampitabhujo kanikabhadato sankirtane kapitarau kamalaya taksau viswambharau dijavarau yugadharma phalo bande jagat priyakarau karuna avataro Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srinivasadi Gauru Bhakta Vrinda Hindi Vasa Lok Samne Aja Bola Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare
Bola Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama Rama Rama
वो चाहते हैं वो जो हम नित्य आनंद में जो सच्चिदानंद रूप है वो सत चित आनंद स्वरूप वो आनंद वो जीव को भी देना चाहते हैं, क्योंकि जो ईश्वर अंश जीव अविनाशी हम सब भगवान के संतान हैं, लेकिन उनको भूलने का वजह से ही जगत में जितने सारे दुख कष्ट है। अभी प्रश्न है हम कैसे सुख पा सकते हैं, तो जब हम स्मरण करेंगे उनका कीर्तन करेंगे उनका भजन करेंगे उनका तभी तो हम आनंद प्राप्त कर सकते हैं। इसलिए बताए भगवान क्यों लीला करते हैं, कहते केवल भक्तों का आनंद देने के लिए भगवान सब कुछ लीला करते हैं।
So the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he in his various incarnations, in his various forms, comes to this planet Earth and performs very beautiful, sweet pastimes. And while he's performing all these pastimes, he is described as Atmana Apakam, means he is satisfied within himself and there is no desire of his that is unfulfilled. So he is enjoying his pastimes with his associates in Guru Vrindavan. Why does he need to compare? He comes here to perform the pastimes so that he will purify us as well. He will also be, by this performing these pastimes, actually he is being merciful on us. And that's why he is performing these pastimes.
जगन्नाथ जी जो स्नान यात्रा है इसके बहुत बड़ी रहस्य है। बोले इसमें क्या रहस्य है? बोले जो जगन्नाथ जी है कौन? बोले जगन्नाथ जी कृष्ण ही ये जगन्नाथ जी का रूप धारण किया है। इसलिए ये कथा को कल हम लोग सुनेंगे कि जगन्नाथ जी ऐसे रूप क्यों हुआ है, इसका कारण क्या है। हाँ, इसको अच्छे तरह से कल हम सुनेंगे। इसलिए जगन्नाथ जी ऐसे रूप किया उसका एक कारण तो तीन चार कारण गुरुदेव ने ग्रंथ में प्रकाशित देखने। इनका जो असली जो रूप है कभी ये कृष्ण स्वयं कहते, कभी राधा रानी को प्रेम को दर्शन करके ब्रजवासियों का प्रेम को दर्शन करके जगन्नाथ जी स्वयं ये रूप धारण किया है, कृष्ण ही जगन्नाथ रूप धारण किया। इसलिए इनके जो मंदिर जो जगन्नाथपुरी में जिस मंदिर में जगन्नाथ जी रहते हैं कहते हैं जो द्वारका पर कुरुक्षेत्र मानिए उसको स्थान कुरुक्षेत्र है यहाँ पर द्वारका मानिए। कृष्ण तो रहते हैं द्वारका में लेकिन दिन रात रोते हैं ब्रजवासियों का नाम लेकर के। जब वो सोते हैं सत्यभामा रुक्मिणी सत्यभामा के साथ में सोते हैं लेकिन रात भर रोते रहते हैं। सत्यभामा का कपड़ा रुक्मिणी की कपड़ा पहनते बोले हे राधे तुम कहाँ हो, हे ललिते तुम कहाँ हो, हे श्यामली हे धवली नंद जसुदा, रात भर इनका नाम को लोग कृष्ण ले लेकर रात भर रोते रहते तब हम उनको साथ में मिलेंगे। ब्रजवासियों का प्रेम निर्मल सुधा प्रेम, इसलिए कृष्ण चाहते हैं साल में एक बार जाऊं कहाँ ब्रज में जाऊं और मेरे राधा रानी ललिता विशाखा और इन भक्तों से एक बार मिलूं। जगन्नाथ जी मंदिर में बड़ी इच्छा होती है, क्यों हम कहाँ जाना चाहते हैं जहाँ हमको प्रेम मिले, वहीं तो जाएंगे ना। जहाँ प्रेम नहीं मिलेगा फिर कोई जाएगा, जहाँ प्रेम मिलेगा सब दुनिया प्रेम का ही भूखे है, लेकिन असली जो प्रेम है वो ब्रज में। इसलिए कृष्ण चाहते जो निष्काम प्रेम करने वाले उनके पास में जाना चाहते।
So Lord Jagannath is performing his pastime. Actually, who is Lord Jagannath? Lord Jagannath is not different from Krishna. He is Krishna himself. For certain specific reasons, Gurudev has published various reasons in the scripture describing the pastimes of Lord Jagannath, and he has described four or five reasons why he has taken this form. That is Krishna has taken this form. One of the significant reasons that we prominent reasons that we know is that out of his affection, out of the attachment, out of his prayer towards Radharani, he has adopted this form. He's melted in prayer towards Radharani. So he's describing that where is the Jagannath staying? Jagannath is staying in Puri. And the temple where he's staying, it's considered as Dwaraka or it's considered Kurukshetra. So if he's staying in Dwaraka, but all the time when he is in Dwaraka, we have heard about this pastime so many times, that when Krishna is in Dwaraka, although he is resting with his queens, Rukmini, Satyabhama, etc., he is staying there with them and sleeping, sharing the same bed with them. But although he is sleeping there in Dwaraka, but all night he is shedding tears. Sometimes it is described that he sheds tears so profusely that his pillows become wet with his tears. And he is pulling the upper clothes of Rukmini or Satyabhama and uttering the name of Radharani, "Hey Radhe, where are you? Hey Lalita, hey Vishakha," he's mentioning the names of all the Brajvasis and he's remembering them, the upper clothes of Satyabhama and Rukmini. So like this, he's all the time remembering the Brajvasis. Why? Because he's had a lot of affection for them and they have had a lot of affection for him. So, and he wants to go and meet them. So at least once in a year he wants, because this is considered as Dwaraka, where his temple is, in Puri, so this, once in a year at least, he wants to go and go to the Braj. So, with some of the other pretexts, he wants to go and...
इसलिए कहते जो रति है रूप गोस्वामी उज्जल निर्मणि ग्रंथ में वर्णना करते रति तीन तरह का है एक रति होता है सामंजस्य रति है एक है समर्था रति है और एक रति है जो कामना वासना युक्त रति तीन तरह का रति वहां पर होता है कहते जो पूजा की जो रति है वो भोग वृत्ति है तो पूजा की रति है हां इसको कामना वासना युक्त रति कहते हैं क्योंकि जब कृष्णा पूजा को पहले तीन जगह से चली थी जब कृष्णा प्लास्टिक सर्जरी कर लिया उसको पूरा सही कर दिया कृष्ण का स्पर्श पाते ही वो इतने सुंदरी हो गई वो अपना रूप जौवन को देख करके संभाल नहीं सके कितने में कृष्णा कपड़े को पकड़ ली बोले कृष्ण ये रूप तुमने दिए है तुम ही भोग कर सकते सामने बलदेव को कड़े कपड़ा पकड़ के जब मैं कंस को मार करके आऊंगा तो तुम्हारी इच्छा तुम्हें पूरी कर दी है इसलिए जिसका रति बताई गई वो कामना वासना युक्त रति है लेकिन एक रति होता है सामंजस्य रति बोले सामंजस्य रति किसकी है इस तरह साधारण रति खूब ज्यादा दूसरी रति है सामंजस्य रति किसको बोले महिषियों को ये सामंजस्य रति बोले सामंजस्य रति क्यों बताए तो यद्यपि ये कृष्ण को प्रेम करते हैं कृष्ण प्रेम समझने के लिए कोशिश करो यद्यपि कृष्ण को प्रेम करते हैं अब देखना शादी को बाद में क्या होता है शादी के बाद में आधा एनर्जी पत्नी को देना पड़ता है अगर दो चार बच्चे हो जाए तो फिर देखना सबके सब जितना प्रेम कुछ पत्नी में चली गई कुछ बच्चे में चली गई कहते वो प्रेम ना बंटवारा हो जाती है ये प्रेम बंटवारा हो जाती है इसलिए कहते हैं महिषियों ने यद्यपि कृष्ण प्रेम करती हैं लेकिन उनका जो रति है वो बच्चों में बैठे हुए और पत्नी में उनकी पति में बैठे हुए कुछ पति में चली गई और कुछ बच्चों में चली गई इसलिए इनकी रति कहते हैं ये सामने जैसा रति जो आधा कृष्ण आधा कहते ये परिवार में लेकिन जो गोपियों का जो प्रेम बताया समर्थ रति बोले समर्थ रति मतलब जिनने शादी नहीं की जिनको बच्चे नहीं इसलिए जो निस्वार्थ जो प्रेम है जो एक पॉइंट है जिसका प्रेम जिसको कृष्ण कहते हैं सर्वधर्मान परित्यज्य माम एकम शरणं व्रज सब कुछ छोड़कर जो एकमात्र हमें जो भक्ति है यदि ये गोपियों की राधा इसलिए इनका जिसका जो इतना प्रेम होता है उतना भगवान को आकर्षण करता है इसलिए भगवान चाहते हैं साल में एक बार मैं जाऊँ और ये ब्रजवासियों से मिलूं कि इनका जो प्रेम है वो सिद्ध प्रेम का कोई कामना वासना नहीं है ये रूप गोस्वामी
That we'll try to analyze why Krishna is anchoring so deeply and so strongly his anchor for the association of the Brajavasis. This is described by Sri Rupa Goswami and Murwillumbah. He is describing there are three types of rati. One is sadharan rati. Sadharan rati means loose translation of sadharan means ordinary or general attraction, general rati. So this is described as the rati of Kuja. Kuja who is having some desires also, for fulfilling her own desires also, and she has attachment or attraction towards Krishna. Like when she is having a hunchback, that time Krishna comes and he holds her by the chin, puts his toe on her toes and he pulls her up. And immediately she loses her hunchback and she develops a very beautiful, attractive form. She's so beautiful, so attractive that even she looks at her own self and how beautiful and how attractive she is. She herself feels that she cannot control this beauty and she has to spend this beauty. So then she approaches Krishna and she holds Krishna's upper cloth and she starts pulling Krishna that, oh, you have given me this beauty, you have given me this beautiful body. It is you who has to consummate this beauty of mine. So it is you who is fit for this beauty of mine. And then Krishna immediately chastises her. He says that, don't you feel embarrassed of what you are doing? My elder brother means, Jade means in English, brother-in-law. So he means he is there, my elder brother Balaram is there, and right in front of him, you are behaving in such a manner. And then he says, let me go now, and I will come back after killing Kansa, and I will fulfill your desire. So here it is described that she has, this is ordinary, or general rati. General rati means she has some desires of her own also to be fulfilled. And then the second is described as samanjasya. Samanjasya rati means in equilibrium. In equilibrium means, you will see that in the beginning, especially when in Western countries, when a girl and a boy are dating, then they have a lot of attraction for each other. And after some time, they get married, and then they have kids, then you will see that the attachment, or the attraction, is divided now. Now the wife has, of course, she is still attracted, any just wife is still attracted to her husband, and still she has attachment for her husband, but now her attachment, etc., is divided between her kids and her husband. And then it is described, this is described as something in equilibrium, which she has, this is described the rati or the prem of the Dwarka Mahishi, the queens of Dwarka. They have, because they are married, and they have children from, they have children also, they are all the queens, so they have some attachment towards Krishna, and some attachment is also divided from Krishna to the kids that they have. But then another rati is described as samartha rati. Samartha rati means that which is fully capable. Samartha means, a little bit translation of samartha means, fully capable. It is fully capable of controlling Krishna. Why is it fully capable of controlling Krishna? Because they have no other attachment. They have no other attraction. They have no division of attention towards anything, anybody else in the world, in the universe. Their one-pointed attachment is towards Krishna. So this is some kind of, it is known as samartha.
इसलिए कहती है प्रेम रति ब्रजवासियों में है, इसलिए कृष्णा चाहते हैं जिसको जितना प्रेम हो वो व्यक्ति उतना ही उसको प्रति आकर्षित होता है, जो जितने प्यार करे आपको अब उसे तो मिलना चाहते हैं ना, लेकिन जिसको पास में जाने का कुछ भी नहीं मांगता, केवल तुम्हारी सेवा ही करते हैं, आप तो ही जाओ ना, बढ़िया अच्छे आदमी है, जो मांगता नहीं बल्कि जाओ खूब सेवा करता, उसको पास में जाना चाहते हैं, इसलिए कृष्णा चाहते हैं निष्काम प्रेम।